So these are the lovely sounds of the Ensoniq TS-12. There's a TS-10 as well. This one's just like the weighted, larger keyboard version. It also, the other difference, which is actually kind of annoying, that I have the TS-12 rather than the 10, is that this one doesn't have poly aftertouch, whereas the other one does. So the other ones are a little bit more sought after. But to be honest, I don't actually care that much because I'm more interested in the sound design qualities of this thing than its playability. So I'm just going to skip through some of these patches like I did with the VFX video. Most of these patches, maybe not, about 50% of them at least, most 50% patches I've made. So I've also got this init patch here, which I think I described in my previous video, where it's just like a saw wave, nothing, everything. Like I actually had to make that so that I would have an init patch, but I'm really glad I did because it's come in really handy. So anyway, I think this might have even been one of the first ones I made for this. So as you can hear, I make a lot of pads on this thing, because like the other Ensoniq stuff, they're just really great for pads. So lush. This one's a bit dirtier. So on this one, this dirt wave, or this dirt patch, it's like, it's a wave list rather than multiple like oscillator waves, which is like the other patches. I think if I go through this, when you select a wave list, you still get a few of them, but you don't get as many, you get four. And then you've got this edit wave list button at the bottom, which I haven't used this very much, this particular feature, but I guess it allows you to select which waves you want to, like, have in the wave list. But if I just solo some of these, that's that part of the sound. Like that's some interesting sort of the interesting stuff you can get with this synth, with Ensoniq synths in general. Like that's a fucking weird sound. So let's do that. So just these two are playing. That's pretty rad. Anyway, so as I mentioned on the previous video with the VFX, which is just sitting just up there, is that these synths, both the TS-12 and the VFX, they don't have resonant filters. And that's kind of a blessing and a curse to a point, but what this synth does have is a massive array of effects. I think this synth basically has the same effects as some of the standalone Ensoniq effects from the 90s and stuff, which were basically like widely regarded to be pretty great. But one of the effects is a resonant filter. Like it's a multi-effect, so it's like a resonant, you know, there are multiple versions of it, like resonant filter with delay, resonant filter with EQ and stuff. But in this case, I've got it set to the pressure or the velocity. So, like, it's not the best sounding resonant filter in the world, but I think it can definitely work as like a, I don't know, like if you don't treat it like that, if you treat it like an after effect, which is it's exactly what it is, because it can't be, it can't affect the voices in the same way as if the as the actual the onboard filter can, if that makes any sense. Anyway, so let's just continue moving through some of these. So this one's a preset, which I liked. I mean, I like it, but I don't think I've ever actually recorded with it. This is one of my patches. This is not one of my patches, but I kind of thought it would be useful to keep around. I think that's a pretty good guitar sound, which I guess is why I kept it. It's got a real nice attack on it. Very nylon string guitar. And then there's this one, which I did make. Oh, no, actually, I did not make this one. I love how I backpedaled real quickly on that one, because I don't like this sound that much. I guess I just thought I should have a mono synth in here, or a mono lead sound. So I would have made this one, I think. Yep. Quite recently, I think I made that one. So that's a pretty nice pad. I also made this patch. It's like a classic sort of sound I like to make. It's just super, super like sharp saw wave, detuned kind of poly pads. I made this one as well. Did not make this one, but it's one of my favorites. I think I've recorded with that before, but it's not the most usable sound. It's just, it's very atmospheric, and it's super, like, it's the most 90s fucking sound on the planet. Like, the height of synthesis at the time. Still sounds fucking great, though. I didn't make this one either, but it's really nice. Did make this one. So, as on the other one, there's this flute sound. I don't think I'm ever going to use that, but like they, maybe I have used it actually, but they have, I just can't, I sort of, if there's a nice flute sound on a synth, even if I'm not going to use it, I just feel like I have to keep it around. I don't know why. I think it's, I like the texture of this, those sort of sounds, those like chiff flute kind of deals. I made this sound. I call it waves because it's got a lot of wavetable stuff happening in it. So I made saw head. I always like to make patches which are just like heaps of saw waves, and this one at the moment is three oscillators of saw waves, but there are others in here which I could, I think I could, don't know, no, I guess not, but hopefully, if memory serves, this will be a large sound. What else have we got? Voxels. I made this one too. What does it sound like? I can't remember. I actually really like this sound, and I've used it a lot, and it is one of mine. And I'm pretty happy with it. So I started out with some of these ones, and those ones are really nice. I made, pretty sure I made those ones. What have we got here? So there's a lot of wavetable stuff going on that one as well. And you can hear it like cycling through in that grainy way. Very cool. I definitely made that sound. I quite like it. What else we got? Boards of Canada pad. Well, my attempt at a Boards of Canada polysynth pad. These bell flow sounds I've used a shit ton. and I made them, and I'm very happy with them. I use them quite a lot, probably more than I should. Belle Floyd 2 is just slightly sharper, more crystalline. One of the things I did recently actually was send my octatrack to this, like sequencing it, but also using parameter locks. I was modulating sounds using the octatrack and the pressure and mod wheel controls. So like I was sending parameter locks to the mod wheel and I was assigning the mod wheel to things like delay time and even like wave table stuff, and getting some really interesting results. So I'm definitely going to explore that further. I think it's really interesting using a modern piece of hardware to dramatically enhance an old piece of hardware. So what we're going to do is I'm going to go to the init patch and I'm going to start a new sound, which is what we've got to begin with. So I'm going to select a trans wave because that's just how I'm feeling right now. Pretty much always feeling like some wavetable synthesis. Trans waves, there they are. So the main difference, or a big difference between this and the VFX, is that so the higher quality samples, just, and there's way more of them. So there's more trans waves, there's more regular waves, and a lot of, and like the recordings of them are way better, but also the actual sample rate's way better. So you end up just with a cleaner sound, which is not always what you want, but it, you know, sometimes it is what you want, and you can still get like gritty sounds out of it. There's more synthesis options, there's more sort of modulation options, and the effects are just way, way superior to the VFX effects. Maybe not like as much in quality as just in breadth. There's just so many of them. So we've got this index value here. That's very handy to have on this page. So you can just cycle through the trans waves. We start with that actually, and I'll put it right up there. I'm gonna make the mod source an envelope. Maybe I can make it velocity actually. Yep, that's it, it's better. Got a bit of a clavinet vibe now. But the way to get a better clavinet vibe would be to actually use an envelope. Envelope 2. Actually, envelope 1. And to keep the mod at the same amount, but when I go to envelope 1, is to basically go to the part where velocity affects the envelope. And then go to the page, mode repeat. Well, it's hardly a clavinet sound, but that's not really what I wanted anyway. What it is a kind of fucked up sound. And I do love a fucked up sound. So, I'm going to give that a bit of release on the amp envelope. And might give it some slight pitch. The LFO. So the LFO's got a bit of a delay on it. Get rid of. I really like the way the wavetable modulation interacts with the pitch modulation. It's very cool. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to modulate the rate of the LFO. And I'm going to modulate it with pressure? No. I guess I could do it with the wheel just to start with so I can sort of hear it. So that's pretty good. I'd kind of like it to be faster than that, but I'm not really sure there's as much I can do about that right now. But what I could do is, what can I do? Well, one thing I can do is I can copy this wave and go back here, paste it. And solo it. And I can go to the wave page. I can change this to LFO. And get rid of the pitch on the LFO. And change the rate to very slow. Change this to mixer, which is the mod mixer. I'm going to put some filtering on this. Get rid of the mod amount, get rid of the envelope. Also, it's at this point where you can start to experiment a little bit by just changing the wave, because I've got all of the modulation happening with the with the wavetables. So if I change the trans wave, I'm just going to get different the same modulation on a different wave. Go back here and change the wave from square to sawtooth. And change this to the mixer, to the mod mixer. Get rid of that. go to the mod mixer. Source, let's go with, shall we say, velocity. Source 2, let's go with the LFO. What will I actually do? That's the real question, because I don't know. Oh, noise. There we go. That's where noise is. God, it's been a while since I've actually edited on this thing. So that's really pretty fucking great, I actually think. But I'm going to give it a little bit more delay so it comes in a bit slower. Change the noise rate to be slower. So what do these two sound like together? This definitely needs some filtering on it. Change the filtering a little bit on this one. So I'm pretty happy with just what's going on there. I feel like if I add any more voices to that, it's going to just get messy, even though I've got another 4 that I could possibly add to it. So I'm just going to leave it like that. What I am going to do, though, is I'm going to add effects, because there are so many effects. Right now there's no effects running at all. So if I go just to delay, chorus, reverb. Definitely adds something, but I can go down here and I can change the variation. Like the variations are just kind of like presets almost, but you can edit them, so it's sort of, it's like nice that you've got a starting point. But if I then, I actually quite like that, but if then I can click the effects button again, I get effects 1 left, right, 2 delay, to chorus. I can change all of that, and I can change like the levels of each of the individual things, the dryness of the dry signal, the reverb signal. It's actually quite confusing. This is like the effects on both this and the VFX are probably the most confusing aspects of them, in my opinion. So the mix of the delay, that's fine, but and the panning is fine, but what I want is more regenerations. And this timing I might want to change as well. Then we've got chorus. I'm happy with that. I don't think I need to change any more of that. I am tempted to see what this sounds like, though, if I change the regeneration on the chorus. Oh, we just get lots of distortion. Thank you. pretty happy with that, got to say. I think I'm just going to leave it. So I'm going to now just quickly save this. I'm going to change the name to, what am I going to call this? Let's just be 100% mature. That'll do. One of my favorite brands from the 90s. Let's go with that. Now I just have to select out of the patch, the bank buttons, where I'm going to save it to. And I'm going to have to overwrite something. So I'm going to overwrite something that I don't like that much. I think I'm going to overwrite this movie string because I just don't think I'm ever going to use it, even though I kind of like the sound. And I'm pretty sure I've got it on a disc as well. Fucked. There we go. Sorry about the distortion. I just noticed that the reason it's distorting is because my preamp is being overloaded. But that's fine. I'll just have to deal with that. So anyway, that's a sort of good rundown of this synth. I'm just going to leave it there. And yeah, I've gone through a bunch of these presets, made a sound. I don't think there are really any videos like this about these synths online. So hope that this is something that people actually want to see. Anyway, I might make more videos about these, about sound design on these later, because there's just so many things you can do. I just don't want to make like super long videos. So anyway, subscribe. Continue watching what I do. If you like it, tell me. Tell me what I can change, if you think I should change anything. This is all like a new experience for me. So anyway, thanks. See you later.